Well, hello, my inky friends. This is Cindy Lynn with My Inky Fingers, and today I have a DIY light up card for you guys. Now, while I'm a Stampin' Up! Demo, today I wanted to play with some non-Stampin' Up! Stamps because I had a specific image in mind that I wanted to make a gnome card for someone special. So I will link as many of the products as I can in the description here on YouTube or on my blog. But I cannot link items that directly compete with Stampin' Up! So to start, I'm gonna create a background on some Whisper White, and I'm gonna use some Distress Oxides, and I'm gonna use mustard seed and spiced marmalade. So I'm gonna use the spiced marmalade kind of in the center and work out with the mustard seed. I wanted to create kind of a sunny day effect. Now, many of you know I profess to suck at scenes, but this one I was so pleased how it turned out. So I just kind of had a little template there that I had used for my digital image that I printed. So I'm just bringing it back and forth and using that oval die just to make sure that I've got the right placement. Now, once I had that all blended up, I wanted to bring out a stencil that I made on my Cricut. And I know everybody's gonna wanna know how, and I do plan on doing a video at some point for that. But this one was a fireworks stencil. And I thought, you know what? This will give the perfect little amount of mini little rays coming out behind my little gnome. So again, I used the spice marmalade in the center and then kind of went out with the mustard seed. And I'm really liking how that turned out. So I was super pleased with that. Now, just to add some more texture, figured I'd bring out my splatters box, and I'm gonna splatter that just with some water. And that's just the mechanism that goes down inside the bottle. And I'm just tapping that on top, use a little piece of paper towel, wipe it off, and then I came in with some white. And then I paused my recording to let it dry, and then I came in with some gold too. So I'll link my sprays and splatters up here for you guys so you can see the gold. I don't have the white mixture up there, but I do plan on doing another sprays and splatters video because you know me and my little concoctions, right? So I did pull out my Copics to color up this cute little gnome. Now, I got this from Sherry Baldy, and I'm gonna put a picture right up here because I altered this gnome dramatically. I didn't want him so feminine because this little guy is supposed to be a boy, and I wanted him to look cute, but I wanted the light in his little hat that I'm gonna do. I really wanted that to stand out, and I found that there was just way too much going on the stamp itself, so I just kind of, I altered it in a program, and I just wanted to show you guys the picture so you didn't think that this was the stamp that you would get, because there's much more to him than what you see here. So I will list all of the Copics that I use down below in the YouTube description and also on my blog, but because I zoomed in here to show you guys the coloring, you can't see my caps, and I thought that's probably not a big deal because I think this is the first time I've ever colored with Copics on my channel. I do absolutely love them, and I hate to throw the Stampin' Blends under the bus, but there's just so many more colors. I have about 200 and I don't know, 20, 30, 40, 200 and some anyhow. And I just love the variety of colors, and I love coloring with my Copics. So I did speed this up quite a bit because this really isn't a Copic coloring tutorial card, but I wanted you guys to see the process anyhow. And I won't play music. I'll just chit chat with you guys while I do it. If you want to see how the card was made and you just want to skip to that, I totally get it. Time is precious. I don't want to waste your time. And I'll put a little thing right up here so that you can skip to how I did the DIY card. So if you want to watch the coloring, yay, we can kind of hang out and chat a little bit. My coloring style is I don't know, I just, I'm self-taught. I go in with the lightest color first, then I bring in my medium tone, and then I bring in my dark tone, and then I work from the beginning backwards again. So I go light, medium, dark, and then I go from the medium back to the light, and then blend it all in, and I just kind of play around with it until it looks like I've got a good blend. Now, a little tip for you guys. I actually wear glasses. I wear, what are they, transitionals, and I am so blind when it comes to things that are directly in front of my face. So I went to the dollar store and I got some plus 175s, I think they are. And they are so perfect for when you're coloring. So if you have a hard time like I do, go to the dollar store and pick yourself up some glasses. And then I just wear them while I'm coloring and then take them off and I'm good to go. So I wasn't wearing them right away in the beginning and I went out of the lines a bunch. So I used my the Zero. And with the Stampin' Blends, it's called a color lifter. It's really not a lifter. What it does is the Zero pushes the ink down into the paper to help it disappear. And you can also use a Sakura gel pen and kind of line over top of where you made some minor mistakes, and that'll help hide it too. So he's pretty much almost done here. Now, one little thing, a cool little tip for you guys when you're coloring, you can do this with any alcohol markers. I wanted a lighter gray than the lightest one I had. So I'm using my Zero and I'm picking up ink from the C3. And when you pick up ink from a marker with your Zero, it just really, really lightens it. So that's kind of how I did his little beard. Hopefully that's a little tip. Nice hair too, Cindy Lynn. You know my pot holder thing I have over top of my table? It's got all the silk flowers on it. I had this super big messy bun and I kept hitting it and it kept pulling my hair out of my bun. It was awful. Anyhow, so for the layering dies, I used the second largest to cut out the gnome, and I also used the third largest just to cut out a scratch piece of paper. You see it there on the right, because that's what we're going to build our little light up fixture on. Now this tool, I don't even know what you call it. It's the one where you put the little pieces in and you pull it out, pull it like boom, like that, and it makes a hole. And then it's got like the little eyelet smasher to hold the eyelets and stuff in. I don't even know what it's called. If you know what it's called, tell me like down below in the comments, because I can't for the life of me remember. I've had that tool for so long. So I'm going to line up this battery, and I will link the batteries. I want to line it up behind his beard, and then I get a good positioning for where it's going to go on the actual cardstock that we're creating our light up mechanism on. I'm going to draw a circle around that, and that the B is just there for you guys so that you know that's where the battery goes. Now what we're going to do is we're going to create two different circuits with the copper tape, and one's going to be a negative and one's going to be a positive. So this is self-adhesive, and I'm just going to pull the backing off of it. And the negative has to be underneath the battery, no matter what. So I'm gonna follow my little trail, and I just drew a little trail kind of where, you know, the circle was gonna go, and you saw me trace it, so I know where that little light's gonna pop up in his little hat there in the flower. So the copper tape was a little wider than I wanted, so I'm cutting it down. I think it was, I don't even know how wide it was. It's in the description, but I wanted to cut it down thinner. I wanted it more like more narrow, I guess, to a quarter inch. So now I'm just going to line up my positive piece. And here's the trick. Make sure that you leave enough on your positive piece with the backing still on it, because this is very important for us to use as an activator to light up our card. So I just snipped a little bit off there, and I use my bone folder just to flatten it all down. Now these lights, oh my God, they're so amazing. There's so many colors in here. I love, 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 love them. So I'm just gonna play with the three yellowy oranges, and the long end of these diodes are the positive, and the short end are the negatives. So I'm just putting them on my battery. The top of your battery is positive, the bottom of your battery is negative. So I'm just sticking them on there just to see what the color looks like. And I like that one, so I'm gonna put the other ones back in the case. And I do have pictures up there so you guys can see what the colors look like. So you see how one is longer and one is shorter? The longer end of your diode connects to your positive, and the shorter end of your diode connects to your negative. So what I'm doing is I'm just bending these, and they're super, super easy to bend. And I'm just trying to kind of form them so that the light bulb sits up, but each of the negative and positive reach the negative and positive little roads that I built there. Now, I don't know why I did this. I wanted to bring those pieces down closer to where the bulb went. And it really wasn't necessary, because as long as your positive and negative somehow touch the corresponding road for your copper tape, and I'm calling them little roads just for visual purposes, right? Now, this is just a piece of cardstock I have with some copper tape on it, because I don't want to fold that little tag on the right just to see if it's working. So I'm just kind of using that to make sure it's working. And then tape is totally fine. Scotch tape, tape it down. And I check it each time I tape it and make sure it's still working. So here I took a break. And remember I told you guys I made that press record sign for myself so that I didn't forget to press record when I came back? What a ding dong. I was so enthralled in making this and my mind was just so deep into this that I came back and didn't even move my press record. So nevertheless, I just cut a little strip of that scrap cardstock so that I could replace the backing off of that copper tape with actual cardstock because you don't want to use the backing. So I've got that all put down there. Now, what I want to do is I want to fold this in a way that it kind of goes over top of the battery because the battery is behind the beard, right? So this is the piece that when you touch it, as you can see there, it's going to light up the little light bulb. So I'm going to use an obscene amount of foam tape. So I pulled out my scotch because I have an abundance of that. And I want to build a little casing, if you will, around where the battery is going to go because you don't want your battery to move, right? Because if that battery moves, then the recipient's going to press wherever they need to press on their card and the battery won't be there to make the connection for your little copper piece, right? So I'm just building this up and trial and error. This is actually the very first time I've ever done this. So I knew I needed two layers. So I'm going to peel all that off and build my second layer. But as it turned out, I went with three layers of foam tape on here. So I just felt that it needed three layers. So, I mean, I've seen other tutorials where they use two, but I didn't want this battery or the light to be accidentally activated. So I used three layers. So this here is two layers, but I'm going to do the first layer all the way around our little battery light up mechanism paper piece there. So I'm just going to cut all of my foam into 1/4 inch and roll it all the way around the edge of this here cardstock. And then I'm going to end up, like I said, doing three layers. Okay. So I did do the two layers and I put it all on and I had to pull it off because it just was too easy for that light to accidentally get activated. So here I've got three layers and I'm just getting it all tight down. And as you can see, when I push his little beard, his little hat lights up. It's so cute. And now I looked at the back and I was like, Cindy Lynn, I don't have enough room to evenly get my foam tape. So I had to pull out my undo. And this stuff is amazing. It will remove anything that is sticker, but it won't take the stickiness away, right? So once it dries, it's still sticky again. It's photo safe. It didn't hurt the battery. It didn't hurt any of the copper tape. It won't make any of your ink bleed. It's fantastic. So now I'm going to go around and I'm going to put three whole layers all the way around this. And now I wanted to create my grass, I guess. And this is just some, what the heck brand was that? I think it was Bow Bunny, actually. Yeah, it was Bow Bunny. And I just wanted to cut kind of along this design and create kind of a ground so that he just wasn't floating in this card, right? So I was pretty happy with that there. And I cut it a little longer so that I could trim it off to match my card. And then I only put one layer of foam on here because I wanted the gnome to pop, right? So I've got one layer of foam on there. And then I'm looking at him and I'm like, you know what? He's got to be blended. He was just way too white. And I'm just going in with the leftover ink off that makeup brush and inked it all around there with the yellow. And then I used the C3. Nice hair, Cindy Lynn. I used the C3 and I just kind of created a little bit of ground so he wasn't floating there in that oval, right? And then I'm looking, and you know me, when it comes to those dimensions and stuff, they gotta be the same color as my card. So I went and used some yellow and just kind of inked up all of the foam. So if the recipient looks at the card from the side, at least it's not stark white, right? So I put an obscene amount of Tombow liquid glue on there because I want this to stick. It's relatively heavy, right, when you think about it. So positioned that all up. Now, I went with the orange stickles because they're glittery and bright, and I figured, hey, those are really going to look cute and match with that little light, right? The sentiment, I printed it on my printer. I just printed it a few times on some scratch paper, and I'm just following the curviness of the word Nomi and, you know, just making it a little bit more interesting, cute there. And I'm going to put one layer of dimensionals on that and pop it up. And then I just use some random, what do you call those, gems or something that I got off of AliExpress or something like that. But there you have it. So thank you so much for joining me today, and I can't wait to see your light up cards. Until I see you again, take care and happy stamping.